Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Mikey, and this is Adam, and we are two guys with raging goals. Every Wednesday, we bring you a conversational podcast with a brand new topic that we bring to the table for your enjoyment. If you like that, follow us at Two Guys with Raging Goals at youtube.com. Like, share, and subscribe to us, and share us with your friends. So you guys, if you watched episode one, you saw that we had some issues. So before we get to the topic today, we're going to kind of do a little bit of a rigmarole.
Yes.
I love that word.
Yes, sir. Rigmarole.
We're going to do a little rigmarole, a little top of the show news to go through. So first and foremost, thank you so much, everybody. Holy smokes.
Yeah.
Way more people watching this than I thought there'd be. Like, yes. I was expecting an audience of about 20 people.
Yeah.
Roughly.
Yeah.
And now we're cruising well past 100, and which makes me a little nervous, to just be honest. Like, I'm like, that's a lot of people watching me.
That is a whole lot of people.
At any given time.
Yeah.
So thank you so much, you guys. Super appreciate all of the support and then the feedback. So just tons and tons of feedback. Very constructive. I guess we haven't really discussed if you've gotten a lot of negative shit, but everybody loves me. So.
Well. Yeah. everybody but me. But
yeah.
I've gotten a lot of feedback. I actually work with this girl, and last week I was overnight. I was working third shift, and she comes in and starts talking to me, and she's like, "Hey, has anybody given you guys feedback about your podcast?" And some of the things that she told me was like, your friend fucking sucks.
Oh, well, I mean,
so
you'll have
so
that.
Let's start
have
there.
That.
No, she didn't.
Brightest
say that.
Star shines.
Okay. All right. So no, one of the things she. This is actually a funny story.
Okay.
Because I'm.
Before we get to the top of the news stuff, now yeah. We're going into a fucking story.
I was exhausted, and this girl said.
Wait, you were because you were working overnight.
Because I was working
when you guys
overnight.
Were talking. Okay. Okay.
So, I'm exhausted, and this girl says something to me, and I completely misunderstood what she was saying. So what she said was something to the effect of, you look really good in front of the camera. And what I thought
is that what you misunderstood?
What I thought she meant was, I look really comfortable in front
okay.
of the camera. And I said, yeah, I know. I feel at home. I feel good. And then she stared at me.
Oh, God.
And in that moment, I realized that what she meant was, you look good in front of the camera. And what it sounded like I was saying was, yeah, you're fucking right I look good.
Yeah, damn right I look good. I was born this way. Woke up like this.
Just, oh my God, a little bit of Beyonce. It's a little early in the morning for you to pull out a Beyonce line. But yeah, so that was some of the feedback.
So some of the stuff that I got, obviously, so one of the things, you guys, and this is kind of top of the news too, we bring this in, we had trouble with our microphones, not only through part of that episode, but then it got kind of heavier as we got to the end of it. So that's why you see we're recording with one mic. Halfway through that first episode, we had to shut off Adam's mic. Essentially, Adam just had to delete the audio out of there. That's why you notice him quieter, which is something you'll never notice or you'll never see in real life. Because,
count your blessings.
Dude's loud as all get out. And that's coming from me. We don't even need walkies when we're in the store with each other to shout from one end to the other. So that's so you see this as a change. One thing, I forget who told me this, but somebody said we talk a lot with our hands, and I said, well, yeah, motherfucker, that's what we do.
It's a video for a reason.
Yeah, that's why it's a video, because we're very animated characters.
Yes,
so,
yes.
The talking with our hands, that's something that's probably not going to go away, but, another thing was, we spent a lot of time talking to each other, or at least I did. Like, I was very, very involved. It was almost like an interview when I'm talking to you, as opposed to maybe talking to the camera once in a while. So, and welcoming you. So,
yes.
So we're making tweaks as we go. You guys will continue to do that. And then I think the other thing that we should bring up is that what we're recording now will come up as episode 2, but it is not the original episode 2.
Yeah, yeah.
Due to the problems we were having with the mics, we had to scrap episode 2, which was a great conversation, I think.
It was. And we'll talk about it again, but yeah. I just don't, like, you know, I don't want it to be today, because, like, I think that...
I think I have a lot to talk about today with
the fucking shit that I want to talk about. We do. We have too many things to talk about. We need to cover this first.
I agree. So that's kind of where we're at, you guys. So this will go up as the official episode 2, and then we'll have more episodes following, hopefully every Wednesday. For those of you guys who maybe haven't seen the first episode, are you showing off your fucking Charmander mug?
I am. I just want everyone to just appreciate this.
Okay, it is a really good mug.
It is really cool. It's a little holographic. It's got a little cute Charmander. All
right.
Gotta catch them all.
Motherfucker. So this will go up as episode 2, and... Adam and I will at some point revisit what we had originally done for episode 2. So I think that's all the business we needed to cover. Was there anything else?
No, there were a few shout outs that we had in episode 2 that I just want to reiterate.
Did I share with you, all the feedback? I won't name names, but the feedback I got from some people about all the shout outs. You know who you are.
Oh my god. Yeah, no, I know who you are too.
I think I shared the GroupMe with you.
Yeah, you did. Okay. Yeah, you did. Okay.
Just checking.
So shout out to those motherfuckers. While we were recording, my Aunt Carol commented on our first YouTube video.
Yep. Oh yeah, I got all excited on the and
yes,
I checked the
yes,
phone.
Yes, and
yeah.
You checked the phone and I berated you.
Yes. Yeah.
And then Eric Castro for tweeting back at us while we were in Kentucky. And where did we go?
We went to El Camino. So we gave a shout out to El Camino as well for like the greatest food on earth.
Amazing service, amazing cocktails.
Yeah. Oh my God. So good. I'd walk back to Louisville for one of those bad boys.
I wouldn't. You gotta get through Southern Indiana for that shit. Yeah. Won't do it.
Won't make it through probably.
Yeah.
Anyway, I think that was smart. And now we can retweet it all of those people, too, and then maybe they'll like it again.
I hope so.
Hey, I mentioned your name. You should like this.
Yes.
So, anyways, I think that's all the business we had to cover. Like we said, you guys, so the topic will be a little out of order. Normally it goes, myself, we'll do a topic for an episode, and then Adam, and then myself, or however we go back and forth.
Yeah.
But this is kind of going to be a combined topic because we both have a lot of rage about this. So what we want to talk about today is kind of a serious topic, really. It's war. And very specifically, the war on Christmas.
And
these fucking red cups.
Yes.
And everybody's problem about that. So that's going to be the topic for the day. I'll open it up to you first, Adam, and just kind of get your take. Maybe what did you find? Like, when did you hear about the red cup fiasco?
So apparently it's been going on for a while. I didn't know about it until about 2 days ago.
Oh, yeah. You are late to this.
Yeah. Okay. But then again, I was third shift last week. I didn't know. I didn't even see the cups. I had no clue. And then I saw somebody post on Facebook about... We'll just
cover off.
Show it, yeah.
So that
yeah.
People can see
it. Well, and here's the issue, is that their sleeve has snow on it.
Yeah.
I think that's a little much.
That's a little much. That's where that's
fuck,
going.
Fuck those people. I don't know. I don't understand why the red cup is a problem.
Me neither.
I don't know. Do you have any insight to me? Why? What are people saying? Why?
So I guess I got to it a little sooner than you did. Sometime last week, I got a Sarah and I, my fiance Sarah, and I went to shout out to Chi-Town.
this episode's just gonna be shout outs. We're gonna do that for 45 fucking minutes, just to make some some people happy.
Yeah, but we won't give them shout-outs.
No, they don't deserve it.
Yep. So we went to Starbucks and whatever, got the cups, and we went about our day, and like I picked it up to take a drink and realized, holy crap, they're the red cups. I'm so excited. I love it when Starbucks changes the cups, because I'm a basic white girl.
Yeah.
So whatever, I was super pumped. I was pumped when they had the fall cups. Have they done that every year?
I don't know. I don't think so. Because when I saw the fall cups, I was like, this is so cool.
Yeah, I was like, oh my god, they're doing fall cups too. Crazy.
Yeah.
So, which will probably inevitably lead to the war on fall. wow. At some point. I don't know.
Maybe. There is a war on fall. Yeah. It's called Christmas.
Yeah, there is a war on fall, and it's being waged by Christmas.
Yes.
And Christmas is fucking a giant, and fucking fall is just like a 5-year-old infant trying to suck on its pacifier or something, and it's like, what the hell?
Yes,
this
sir.
Behemoth beat me with a sack of oranges.
Yep.
Or a sack of pine cones, because it's Christmas.
Because it's Christmas.
Yeah.
They're scented.
Yeah, cinnamon.
Cinnamon pine cones.
So, whatever. I saw the cup, thought it was really cool. That was about all I had. And then, it might have been later that day, or the next day, I saw, I think it was a BuzzFeed article about people who were very, very upset about the red cups. And at first I thought it was just a design thing. Like, oh, like we don't like that they went to this like weird cranberry ombre, whatever the fuck they're
doing. Yeah, you thought it was a Pantone
problem. Yeah, exactly. And I was like, I'm an art kid and I don't have enough fucking in me to be upset about that. But
yeah.
Whatever. I thought it was kind of cool, but I could see like, oh, well, they're just solid red. Maybe some people don't like that simple design or whatever.
Yeah.
And then as I'm reading the article, they're showing pictures of people like holding up the old cups that had snowflakes on them and a snowman, or there's one that's like a dog with antlers on it or something. It was like dressed up as Rudolph or something.
Oh,
right. Like that.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
It wasn't a deer, and I just couldn't fucking tell that it was a deer. But anyway, so they're showing all these cups and like, go back to these Starbucks and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, okay, again, I don't really care about the design. And then they showed tweets from these people attached to them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, I'm never buying Starbucks again. I won't support your anti-Christian coffee place. And I was like, whoa.
Where did this come from?
I was like, whoa. Hands up. It was like, it was just like when in Harry Potter.
Oh, God.
Dumbledore in the movie comes down the stairs in the Goblet of Fire and grabs and shakes the fuck out of Harry. And he's like, did you put your name in the Goblet of Fire? And he's like abusing him and smacking him in the fucking face and shit. And I was just like, whoa.
Oh,
whoa.
That escalated quickly.
It got crazy. So, yeah, that was my initial reaction. I was taken back a lot and I just didn't understand it. And I guess to this day, I still don't understand it. A week later, I don't get it. And so it's become another piece of this ongoing thing. And this has been a few years now where they've talked about this supposed war on Christmas.
Yeah.
That somehow this, and they tie it to religion, right? So it's not just a war on Christmas, which to me is not a religious holiday. Like, I understand its origins and I understand that it's about the birth of baby Jesus and all that stuff. Like, I get that. And I have a lot of religious friends. I have religious family. Like,
yeah,
I understand all of that. I was raised, both raised Lutheran.
Yep.
Yeah. And, so like, I get all of that. And I understand the roots of Christmas, but I don't like when you talk about a snowflake on a cup, you're not talking about Jesus. You're talking about the Christmas season. And that's,
yeah. Toys. Well, and it's about winter. I think it was last year or a couple years ago, there were nutcrackers on the cup.
Yeah. Yeah.
What does that have to do with religion?
And what does that have to do with Jesus or being a Christian or whatever religion you want to put on that?
Yeah.
That celebrates Christmas. It's not a goddamn war on Christmas if that's where you want to go with this. If you're trying to say that taking snowflakes off a cup is somehow a war against your religion, you're fucking batshit crazy, because it's not a war against anything, but if it were, it's a war on winter.
Yeah. Yeah.
I took down the fucking snowflakes and the snowman, which didn't show up in the fucking Bible at all.
No, like, no. And at the end of the day, like, first of all, you gotta respect the fact that people have artistic freedom. Like, it's a red cup. It's a simple design. It looks streamlined. Okay, it looks
and to
good.
Be fair, it's a red and green cup. Red and green. I'm just...
Yes. Yes.
Just point that out.
Oh, God.
I feel like that should be said.
You're going to be on this for, like, months. Yeah. You're going
to... It's going to be bad.
You're going to talk about this forever.
Could barely sleep last night thinking about it because I saw another fucking thing about it.
Oh, God. But it doesn't snow everywhere. Christmas is the same time every year, and it doesn't always snow wherever you are. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, exactly. There aren't snowflakes in Florida, but
What do you need a snowflake on a cup for?
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, like the people who are upset about this are the same people who were upset when people stopped going to Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
After that announcement. And it's like, okay, so when it was Chick-fil-A, he should have an opinion and people shouldn't boycott Chick-fil-A.
Right.
Because of his opinion.
Yeah, and in fact, we're all going to go out and vote with our wallets and blow up Chick-fil-A that day, which was like a huge sales day for them. It was fucking insane.
Hey, good for them.
Yeah.
Good for them.
I love some hateful chicken. Yeah. Fucking love Chick-fil-A. I don't care if they support your gay agenda or not. I love Chick-fil-A. I will eat that hateful chicken all day.
Yeah. I won't buy their chicken, but I'll eat it.
Yeah. No, exactly.
I mean, I've had one Chick-fil-A sandwich since that debacle, but somebody bought it for me.
Way to make a stand.
And I do, you know, hey. Wait. The money's gone either way. The money is gone either way.
What do you want me to do? Let that chicken go to waste?
Yeah. Yeah. I'm not going to. I love food.
Yeah.
I love food. But yeah, so I think it's funny how that double standard is, and the bigger, more salient point is that Starbucks didn't say we're not gonna stand for this Christian Christmas.
Yeah, exactly. And that's the other thing, is that people have come out and put words into Starbucks' mouth, essentially, and said they took it off of there to be more politically correct.
And more secular.
Yes, so that we're not offending Muslim or Jews or any other sect, right? We are making it this two-tone red cup so that nobody's upset. Well, guess what? It fucking snows if you're Jewish, too. Like, yeah, I don't understand, like, taking... They've made it into Starbucks is going too political correct. They're trying to appease everybody, and it's like, no, you have taken over iconography of winter and somehow called that yours, and it's not. They didn't have Jesus on the cup and then take it off. All right, like, and if they did that, which they probably should, because that would be fucking weird, but. If they did that, you'd have some sort of argument that, like, hey, this was a Christian-based company somehow, and they had Jesus on the cup for whatever reason, and they took it off, and I'm pissed. While a strange argument, it is a valid argument that, like, you know what, you got a point there. Sure, it seems like they're going away from your religion because they were balls deep in it.
Yeah, yeah.
But they didn't do any of that. All they did was take a goddamn snowflake off a cup, and they probably designed this cup, looked at it, and were like, dude, this is gonna kill. It's a statement cup. It's gonna be brilliant.
Yeah.
But somehow people have turned this into a politically correct argument that, and this is the problem with the world. We're going too politically correct. We're trying to do too much, which...
I know. You're going to go down that road. Don't do it.
I'm flirting with that line.
Don't do it now.
Yeah. I can't say it enough that, like, it's okay to try to be somewhat politically correct.
Yeah.
I agree. Like, you don't need to, like, there are lines of you go way too far. And it's like, there's no need to be upset about this. Like, no one was offended about it in the first place.
Yeah.
But there is reason enough to be like, hey, if we put Jesus on this cup, do you think that's offensive to some people? Should we maybe not do that? Even if that's what you believe. Like, that's, say it was Starbucks' creed and motto to go up the hill every Sunday and pray to Jesus.
Yeah.
That's fine. But if they made, if they took a second and were just like, ah, maybe that's going to offend some people, that's being thoughtful.
Yeah.
That's not being too politically correct. That's not going out of your way to appease everybody. That's, hey, you know what? Maybe this could be offensive to some people, so we should think about it before we take the next step. But again, they didn't do any of that. They just took a goddamn snowflake off a cup.
Yeah. Well, and beyond that, it's not a statement. They are not saying anything with this cup except for happy fucking holiday.
Like, yeah, which is another problem. Oh my God. I don't know how we didn't get to this already.
Yeah. You go.
Okay. Yeah.
Hit us with it. Cause I was going to bring it up too.
Okay. So you said the phrase happy holiday, which, I don't give a fuck. I don't care if, like, and I, and sometimes I even do it to people intentionally. They'll say happy holiday to me and I'll say, yeah, you can say Merry Christmas to me. I'm not going to get offended because I don't care. The holiday is called Christmas. So I don't care. And so when people are that careful, that does kind of make me like, you don't need to do that. Like, and I get that some people get a little wishy-washy and so they feel that you're being too, whatever, you're being rude when you say Christmas. If I say Merry Christmas to someone, I'm not trying to devalue or disenfranchise. That's not disenfranchise. That's not the word that I wanted, but it's what I'm going with.
Stick to it. Stick to it. You're making a point.
If you own it, you just go with it. Yep. And no one will even know. We'll just do some fancy editing. We can't even get the mics to work, but we'll edit that out.
Yeah, we will.
So anyways, I have no problem either way, right? But an interesting thing has happened with these red cups now, and you should share your story, because you actually, you had boots on the ground for this one.
Boots on the ground. So I was at a sort of Starbucks establishment one day.
A franchise. Kind of.
And a patron of that establishment told the barista to write Merry Christmas on their cup.
Which is some sort of, first of all, that's a weird power trip.
That is psychotic. I cannot imagine.
Say my name again. Say it.
Yeah, I don't understand
that. What the fuck is wrong with you?
I don't even need that person to write my name on the cup.
Yeah.
First of all.
Like, no.
You know what? As long as I get my fucking caffeine, we're going to be okay. And we're all going to make it out of this building alive.
Ritalin crazy Adam over here, people. Yeah. Can't feel his fucking face right now.
But, no, it's just, I don't understand. I cannot imagine walking up to someone and saying,
you write fucking Merry Christmas on this cup.
You know what? When they bring the white cups back on Memorial Day, I'm gonna say, right, we support our troops on the fucking cup.
Like, I'm gonna throw it in your face.
Or I swear to God, scalding hot coffee will be all over you. And I'm gonna be shaking like I am right now.
With rage. And that's, you know, I don't understand that point to a lot of things. So for those of you guys who haven't been following the story, that there's been an outcry or like a call to action. Call to action to all good people to request that your barista write Merry Christmas on the cup so that they have to say it to you. Which I don't care. I'll say Merry Christmas, as I said, either way. However, how is that affecting any change? Because not only are you probably driving the barista and or anybody else who's working at Starbucks and overhears that further away from your point, because they're like, wow, this guy's a dick and controlling as fuck. Somebody call because I think he's married and that's probably an abusive relationship. But even if you get them to say Merry Christmas and somehow that brings them closer to God, even if that happens, you're not voting with your wallet. And that, what I mean by that is, you know, just like with Chick-fil-A, when it came out that he was this president, the CEO, was anti-gay marriage or anti your fucking weird shit that you do.
I don't know. Whatever the fuck it is that you're into.
when that came out, there was the, hey, we're not going to go to Chick-fil-A, we're going to boycott it because you're voting with your wallet. Then you're showing them that, hey, your sales are going to be affected because of your choices, which didn't really work anyways. But that's a clear line of thought, right? Like, hey, I don't like you and I'm not going to support you but with my hard-earned money. But the outcry for this, or the call for action is, everybody go to Starbucks and teach them a fucking lesson. We'll show them by spending our money there.
Oh, God damn it. I hope they bring the red cups back.
Yeah, no shit.
Like, good for them. Like, they are going to have a killer fourth quarter every year. Just fucking. They're taking your dollar bills and they.
You know what Charlene's doing right now? Just fucking getting paid.
She knows. She knows.
Because, like, it doesn't make any sense. So the people who we've pissed off are intentionally going to our stores and buying coffee.
Yep.
So where is the downside? How are you punishing Starbucks, or how are you showing them that I disagree with you? I don't think this is a good idea and we shouldn't be doing it this way. There's nothing. There's no consequence for Starbucks except for to maybe take the fucking green off of it next year.
Yeah.
And be like, what are you guys going to do now?
Yeah.
You guys going to throw fucking fistfuls of cash at us? Don't even buy the coffee. Just throw money at us. That'll teach them.
Yeah.
And then the last point that I have on that little tirade of writing Merry Christmas on the cups is, even if you get the barista to somehow convert to Christianity or whatever other sect of religion you're talking about here, and somehow giving Starbucks your tainted money is teaching them a lesson.
Yeah.
Who the fuck, like, the CEO don't care.
No.
The franchise owner, most likely not there.
Yeah.
Because they're not the ones serving you coffee, whether you know that or not. It's somebody being paid like $7-$8 an hour. Probably, even though Starbucks seems like a great place to work, was out late last night, fucking tired, had a fight with their friend, family member, whatever, has their own fucking life going on.
Yeah.
And you come into Starbucks and treat them like shit.
Yeah.
You come into a place and go, hey, fuck you, write this on my cup.
And say it.
Yeah.
And look into my eyes as you say it.
I want to see it on your lips. Lick them. like, what the fuck is wrong with you that you are treating this barista who makes probably minimum wage or just slightly better, but they do have health benefits, because go Starbucks.
Go Starbucks, yes.
You're treating them like shit.
Yeah.
Because you disagree with that company's stance.
Well, and beyond that, like, people who do this, and they do it every year. We've worked in retail. People will ruin the holiday for you.
Oh, yeah.
Like, all I want is, I would love to love the holidays, but it's been
beaten the fuck out of you.
That small animal that lived inside my heart in a cozy little home next to a fire has been fucking murdered because people.
I am listening. I am engaged. I just had to see what was going on. I'm sorry, my boss doesn't let me. I have a problem. It's a sickness.
It is a sickness.
I tried to blame it on him, but
it's not.
It's me.
It's just you.
Yeah, it is.
It's not. It's not you. It's me.
Yeah.
But, like, why can't we all just be happy? You know what? I don't care. I love working a ton during the holidays.
Oh yeah. Fourth quarter, no rules.
I love it. Do not come to me with a piss poor attitude.
Yeah.
And tell me how bad your fucking day is. Because I'm here and I'm working hard so that your day isn't as horrible as it could be.
Yep.
You know, and it's the same point for those Starbucks baristas. I feel so bad for them, and I abhor the fucking people who decide to go in there and cause fucking mayhem. That's insane.
Yeah, and it's insane. It's, I mean, the bottom line is, you know, we should all be treating each other decently, right? But, like, unless somebody's done something to you, which, if you feel personally slighted by Starbucks, write them a letter. Jump on that tweet campaign or the fucking, we're not supporting you even though I'm holding a cup from you. Merry Christmas. Don't treat the barista like shit. Don't go in there in a rage. Like, They have nothing to do with it. They don't. No. They don't make the fucking decisions for the cups.
They're breaking down trees and like making paper and building the cups in the back. Like no, that's.
You think the barista at your local Starbucks went to fucking Africa, found the beans, ground them up, decided on the cup design, and then fucking put it in there and was like, "Here you go." And even if that were all true, maybe you should be even more fucking thankful.
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah.
Jesus. The reason for the season.
The reason for the season.
So that kind of brings me back to the larger topic. So we went on the tirade here about Starbucks, but the war on Christmas. So that's the new battlefront, right? Like that's where the enemy lines are now. It's right there at Starbucks. They're fighting the good fight for the rest of us.
Right. Right.
But the war on Christmas is bullshit. And I don't care what the fucking Fox and Friends have to say about it.
Yeah.
Papa Bear.
Bill O'Reilly?
Yeah. Carrying it forward for Stephen Colbert.
Shout out to Bill O'Reilly. Yeah. Watch our podcast. Yeah.
You'll love it.
Enjoy. We're gonna be, what is that? He does pinheads?
Oh my God.
We're going to be the pinheads.
There you go.
Yeah.
That'd be great. Oh my God, we'll blow up.
Oh God damn it.
The war on Christmas, it's bullshit. And I know they put out a lot of stuff about how, oh, you can't even put up a manger scene here, or you can't do this, or you can't do that. It's bullshit. So we work retail. I've worked retail for 9 years now. And every year, excluding this year, we have moved the opening of Black Friday further and further into Thanksgiving, to where Thanksgiving no longer exists.
Yeah.
The time when people normally eat dinner, which, okay, I'll give you Thanksgiving. Dinner is normally early for some fucking reason. Like, that's just a written law that, like, hey, guys, we're eating dinner at 2 p.m.
Well, it's so that you can go out for Black Friday and now buy a bunch of shit.
Now like, it is. That's perfect. Some genius saw that and was like, hey, you know that weird thing where we eat Thanksgiving dinner like 7 hours before we should be?
Let's move it to lunch.
We'd fucking take over that span of time where people have been like digesting their food and like eating more pie than they should and fucking pounding beers.
Maybe that.
Let's have them come out and shop during that time.
Maybe it's like the FDA. Maybe they're the ones that are like contributing.
Yeah.
They're like, you know what? We're gonna fight obesity.
Yeah, that's what they're doing. Jesus.
That's what it is.
So, and for those of you who don't get the reference, Black Friday is the official start of the holiday season, as they call it. And that holiday is Christmas. So, it's eaten Thanksgiving.
Yes.
And as I said to you yesterday, it's got its eye on that fucking pumpkin.
Yeah.
Because in the last few years, at Target, we have set Christmas and Halloween at the same time.
Yeah.
So, we set Halloween and a few runs of Christmas.
Yeah.
In October. At the beginning of October.
At the beginning of October.
It's not like, oh, it's October 28th, start setting Christmas, which is still crazy. Yeah. It's at the beginning of October, if not the end of September.
No, it's September.
Yeah.
Because it's right after back to school.
Exactly.
And
so back to school ends, and we immediately put out Christmas. So don't fucking tell me that there's some war being waged on Christmas and like they're a goddamn infant trying to fight somebody.
Yeah, yeah.
They've got a baseball bat and they're swinging it pretty fucking hard at everybody's nuts.
Yep.
All right? Like, like Christmas is winning.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah,
nobody's losing for Christmas. And every year, retailers do more and more to support that, which, hey, I work retail. Bring the money.
Yep.
Just
And I love the holidays.
Yeah, yeah. I love fourth quarter.
I love the holidays at work.
Yep.
It makes me so happy. I get to interact with guests, and I get to like just have fun at work.
Yeah.
And like don't tell me that that's not, you know.
Yeah. Don't tell me that's not and this year in particular, it was when November 1st hit. Decorations can go up in your house. Trees can go up. Everything can go up. That used to be, the cutoff used to be Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Hey, as soon as Thanksgiving's over, we're going to all put up the tree. We're going to decorate with the lights. We'll have a merry fucking December. But that doesn't exist anymore.
No.
Like, if you're starting at November 1st, it's like, oh, yeah, you're starting right on time. And anything before that is like, oh, you're a little early for Christmas.
Yeah, because it's fucking October.
Yeah, what the fuck?
And what people should be saying is, it's fucking November.
Yeah, that's what the conversation should be. Hey, it's November and you're putting up the tree. That seems a little early. I had people, guests in my store who said, hey, I've got most of my Christmas shopping done, which, A, good for you, because...
You're a smart person.
You are ambitious.
You're good for you.
Yeah.
Good for you.
But that's where we're at as a society, and whether you like it or not, that's the truth.
Yes.
So there's no shades of gray there. That's the truth.
Hunt the truth.
Yeah. Hashtag hunt the truth. that's what's going on in the world, whether you like it or not. These are hard and cold facts of dates that when things happen, and what confuses me is when I bring this argument to people, they say, "Oh, but you're talking about like the consumerism of Christmas. That's different." Is it? Because the same people are making the argument about snowflakes on a cup coming off, and somehow that correlates to Jesus being born, but you spending all your money in my store or at other retailers 2 months before Christmas even happens for Christmas, you don't correlate.
Yeah.
So it's all the same thing. It's all for this holiday season. Which, when I first ever heard the term holiday season, I just assumed they made it that large because it was getting so large. So they were encompassing Thanksgiving, Christmas, and New Year's, all as, it's the holiday season.
Yeah.
And that made it easier, and it made it a bigger ploy to be like, oh, well, we can start setting Christmas now. Hey, it's okay to start shopping now because it's the holiday season.
Yeah.
As soon as November 1st hits, we're in the holiday season, so it's go time. And it's like a consumerism thing to be like, oh yeah, then it's fine to shop because it's that time. It's go time.
Yeah, yeah.
So don't fucking tell me that Christmas has a war being waged on it and you're fighting the good fight over there, Bill O'Reilly, trying to stand, you're a lone survivor standing up for what's right.
Yeah.
No,
yeah.
Motherfucker, there are lines around the building standing up for Christmas.
Yeah.
Yes. It doesn't need anyone to fight for it.
It's huge. It's gigantic, and people are going to celebrate it their own way.
It's PCV time.
Oh, damn it. And my computer's talking.
This is the production value that you get here at Two Guys with
Three Mics. I feel like I need to just turn this mute it. There we go. Okay.
Now, does that mute?
It doesn't mute.
Seems like it's fine.
Yeah, it doesn't mute us. It just mutes.
I don't know how things work.
Yeah. All right. Well, I think that this is a good wrap up. I think we've covered all of our bases.
Pounded that nail into the ground.
Target and Starbucks are going to be at our door.
Yeah. No shit. We're getting tomorrow. Cease orders from everybody. Well, not Starbucks.
Yeah. Starbucks is like
shouting us out.
Those are our people.
Yeah.
Look us up.
The Lone Crusaders over here. God.
All right.
I think that's good. So you guys, thank you again for tuning in. Again, I'm Mikey. This is Adam. We are Two Guys with Raging Goals, and we'll see you on the next one. Thanks.
Happy holidays.